limitations has necessitated that I go from here again. In much horror, Eric is sent back by a time loop. I can't explain this, ladies and gentlemen. It just happens to be.
As we commend your souls to Aetherius, blessings of the eight divines upon you.
For the love of Talos, shut up and let's get this over with.
As you wish.
Come on! I haven't got all morning. My ancestors are smiling at me, Imperials. Can you say the same?
As fearless in death as he was in life.
Well, I can only assume that Raelof was, you know, either thinking about regrouping with the rest of the Stormcloaks, or hoping that he could wait it out within the watchtower.
To the block prisoner.
Either way, it was probably not too wise for Raelof to seek a blind end. But, you know, that's how things go. You can't always be so well prepared.
What in oblivion is that?
Sentries. What
I've always admired the executioner. Despite of the fact that he can hear a very loud roar behind him, he doesn't pause for a single moment to consider that perhaps he should turn around. I wonder, can I see the executioner? Does he die? I don't see him nearby. Might as well. Okay, where's the tower? Oh, wrong way. Oh, shit. The sky is abust with flames and fire. Come on, let me in.
What is that thing? Could the legends be true?
Legends don't burn down villages.
We need to move now!
Yes, we do. Hope they won't crash in me again. Oh, shh! Eric draws back. After the very close encounter, the dragon. Peeking out for a moment until he takes a jump. And with certain feet lands in the burnt out house in the tavern. Such greatness is hard to achieve, but Eric manages.
Kevin, you need to get over here! Now! Atta boy, you're doing great!
Oh.
Kural! Still alive, prisoner? Keep close to me if you want to stay that way.
Gunner, yeah, no. Not after you try executing me. Shame. Notice the fact that Hadwar doesn't even attempt to stop the dragon. Clearly he's a bad soldier. Do you have anything to say now, Talius? Okay. We'll have it later. Yeah, it doesn't seem very eager to die. Oh dear, not bad, not good, but not good.
You're not stopping us this time. Fine, I hope that dragon takes you all to Sovereign Lord. You, come on, into the keep.
Clearly, Eric follows the Nord way. Because he's a true Nord. A true son of Skyrim. Ouch, Hazel, ouch. I was trying, but you know, my hands were tied.
and headbutting him while he was surrounded by soldiers didn't seem very wise.
Looks like we're the only ones who made it.
He would have considered it if he knew he'd had a chance of actually killing Tullius. But you know, he's the Nord. He has a certain drive surviving.
Better get moving. Come here. Let me see if I can get those bindings off.
Okay, I trust you.
There you go.
Well, collection map. Okay, let's see. Items. Let's get some proper...
Lanyar isn't coming back.
I should probably take the items first.
Take his armor and anything else on him.
Eric feels a bit bad about looting the items from the dead Gonja. But you know, he's dead. He's not really going to use it. And Eric still happens to have fresh blood spurting within his veins. His need is a bit greater.
See about that gate.
Take a moment to admire. Perfection.
Damn. No way to open this from our side.
Come on, soldier! Keep my cover! Get this gate open.
Yep, take that. Oh. This Imperial captain is clearly feisty. Seeks a chance, executing a fallen soldier. Imperial dogs deserve no mercy. She falls.
Maybe one of these Imperials had a key.
Eric has taken two lives on this day.
Let's see here. Here we are.
Quickly stop, salute everything of use.
Found the key.
Armor isn't cheap. That's a bit of gold to be made. A few septims to be made on looting.
That's it.
And although it does not behoove him, these Imperial boots, this Imperial armor, might serve a greater purpose as a disguise.
Come on. Let's get out of here before the dragon
breaks. No one will suspect him.
Let's keep moving.
Let's make the story a bit more believable by a good Imperial sword. I mean, terrible Imperial sword. Look at this piece of junk. Terrible. Hopefully they were Imperial soldiers and not proud Nords.
That dragon doesn't give up easy.
Grab everything important and let's move.
Clearly Imperial scavengers are trying to lessen the chance of good Nord survivors by stealing everything. Such greed. Such corruptness.
Bastard! You bastard!
Perfect. There's no submission.
Storeroom. See if you can find any presents. We'll need them.
Indeed, it does seem weird that armor made for lean Imperial woman should fit Eric so perfectly. But fear not, there's an explanation, and I'll be sure to come back to you when I have it. Until then, I'll just be stealing this. They won't be needing it. Couple of ingredients for a rabbit. Lovely. Now the first couple of ingredients for... Oh, and salt. Now we have quite a few ingredients for Eric's infamous stew.
Done. Let's get moving.
Clearly, Imperials have been hocking food for themselves in these harsh times. Ah, a torture chamber! The worst fears have been confirmed. Imperials are torturous oppressors, not fit for survival.
Must have run off. Was Jarl Ulfric with you?
No, I haven't seen him since the dragon.
Get strong sword arm, my friend.
Wait a second. Looks like there's something in this cage.
We'll be taking that.
See if you can get it open with some picks. Might need that gold once we get out.
A passing book catches Eric's glance. The Book of the Dragonborn. It seems weird that this book should be placed right here. He flips through the pages, knowing not exactly what the content is, and resigns himself to read it later, but for now surely it isn't of any importance. Lockpicks and healing equipment. Going backwards, he notices a few lockpicks. Surely they will be useful later. Guile and cunning isn't Eric's most fantastic craft, but still he manages to at least make an attempt of cracking the lock open. And even with his first lockpick, he manages to bring it open and robs the poor dead mage of his few belongings. There's much gold and septims to be made from dead mages. He knows this to be true. Empty cells telling sad tales. Surely, Imperials didn't need to go such length to suppress their own population. Lockpicking is seemingly a craft it takes very easily to.
Better to stick together down here.
He should be able to pass through the area relatively unseen, now that he's disguised as one of them. Unfortunately, he's also followed by three stormcloaks. That will surely reveal his true identity, so rather than using guile, he charges forward, attempting to impale the Imperial soldiers. Quite handily manages to do the first one in. These Imperials, they can hardly stand a small beating. How will they ever be victorious? Cabins are damp and rather cold for poor Eric. he struggles on, determined to make it out. But a chance catches his eye. A chance for more loot. He sneaks stealthily into the side chamber, picking up a purse placed rather conveniently beside a dead skeleton. Profits can be made rather easily in times of war. And as long as the gold goes to him, it benefits all of Skyrim. So Eric thinks. Clearly, he is no fool. Spiders, overgrown vermin, easily dispatched by a ready hand. Oh, another one awaits, eager to meet its end. Calm down. Even the poison running to his veins is no deterrent. Something catches his glance, a bear, a hulking form made of muscle and sinew. Rather than passing it by, he decides to flicking upon his grim wounds, and with an easy swipe, he finishes off the beast. Even a bear is no challenge for Eric. And yet, freedom awaits. And Skyrim awaits. Entering the frigid cold air,
wait!
Eric pauses, hearing the flapping of wings, and sneaks stealthily forward, covering behind the rock. And Draken passes by.
There he goes.
And he resumes.
Looks like he's gone for good this time.
Safety.
No way to know if anyone
to.
Else made it out alive. But this place is going to be swarming with Imperials soon enough. We better clear out of here. My sister, Gerder, runs the mill in Riverwood, just up the road. I'm sure she'd help you out.
Alright.
It's probably best if we split up.
Oh.
Good luck.
Okay. Sure. We'll off. I'll see you in Riverwood? Yeah. Riverwood. Bye. Yeah, okay. Bye. Real off. You're supposed to... Go ahead. You said we should split up. Yeah? Okay, good. Go with... No. You said we should split up. Go split up. Pausing once more to take in Skyrim's beauty, he looks around, enjoying the... Goddamn, Raylof. Go away. Trying to monologue. Enjoying the frigid, cold air, and a glance of green trees once again.
You know, you should go to Windhelm and join the fight to free Skyrim. You've seen the true face of the Empire here today.
Eric is suddenly getting very impatient with Raylof. Seemingly he does not understand the meaning of his own words. Splitting up seemingly has another meaning for one such as Raylof. So instead of pausing, Eric breaks into a wild sprint, seeking to avoid the over-eager Stormcloak, and seeks towards a familiar place, seeking out the Wardstones, known to grant warriors, magi, and rogues their favor alike. He pauses only shortly, being all too familiar with the stone he himself is vowed to use. He says a quiet prayer to Talus before turning, heading towards Riverwood. Now grounded the boom of the stone, enough has seemingly realized that splitting up doesn't mean going together. As such, Eric continues on with the journey, appreciating the solitude. And there, in the distance, a wolf catches his glare. He checks his satchel, having seemingly gathered some arrows along the way. Pulling the string, he attempts to deliver a certain shot at the beast. Seemingly he does not manage. Switching towards some more familiar weapons, he draws his sword once more, determined to end these beasts quite handily. Wolves are determined to do so, and such. Railoff is seemingly still not quite grasped the concept of solitude, but for once, the group determines to accept it. What is better, without any semblance of doubt, to live. Even if it means accepting the fact Railoff is not quite capable of grasping such single concepts as splitting up. Alright. Riverwood lays in front of him, and as such, Eric pauses a moment to consider the journey. And we'll be taking a short break.